The cost in dollars to produce X computers in a factory is given by the function. Determine and interpret the average rate of change from x equals 0 to x equals 200 and from x equals 400 to x equals 600. To determine the average rate of change, we need to determine the slope of the secant line passing through the function at x equals 0 and x equals 200, as well as at x equals 400 and x equals 600. So we'll start by determining the slope of the secant line from x equals 0 to x equals 200. But to do that, we'll first have to determine the points on the function when x equals 0 and x equals 200. So we'll start by doing that. So we know one x-coordinate is 0. We know the other x-coordinate is 200. And now we'll use the calculator to determine the y-coordinates, or the function values. So the first thing we'll do is type the function into y equals. I've already done that. And now we'll make sure the table set is set on ask. So we'll press second window. We want to make sure that the ask feature is highlighted here. Once it is, we can press second graph and then type in our x values. So we have 0 and we have 200. So our y coordinates are 0 and 100,000. Now here's the equation to determine the slope given two points. So we'll call these the ones, x sub 1, y sub 1, and we'll call these the twos. So the slope of the line passing through these two points will be our average rate of change on this interval. So y2 minus y1 will be 100,000 minus 0, that's 100,000, divided by x2 minus x1, that's 200. 100,000 divided by 200 is 500. So this is the average rate of change from x equals 0 to x equals 200. But to interpret this, it's helpful if we write this as a fraction and then take a look at what the change in y and the change of x is actually measuring. Well, y is the cost in dollars, so this would be $500. And x is the number of computers, so this would be $500 per one computer. And this helps us interpret the meaning. So the average rate of change is $500 per computer on the interval from 0 to 200. So the average rate of change in cost is $500 per computer on the interval x equals 0 to x equals 200. That's important because if this interval changes, we would expect the average rate of change in cost to change as well. So before we consider the interval from 400 to 600, let's take a look at this result graphically. We just found the slope of the secant line, which would be the line passing through these first two points on the left, so it would look something like this. And again, the slope of this green line represents the average rate of change on the interval from 0 to 200. Now let's determine the average rate of change on the interval from x equals 400 to 600. So again, we'll start by determining the two points on the function at these values of x. So one x coordinate is 400 and the other x coordinate is 600. And now we'll go back to the calculator. And now we'll type in x equals 400 and x equals 600. So we have 160,000 and 180,000. And now we'll determine the slope of the line passing through these two points. Again, we'll call these the ones and we'll call these the twos. The slope is the average rate of change on this interval. So we have y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So it looks like we have 20,000 divided by 200, which is equal to 100. And again, to add some meaning to this, we'll write this as a fraction. So the change in y is $100 and the change of x is one computer. So we can see that the average rate of change in cost has decreased dramatically on the interval from x equals 400 to 600. So the average rate of change in cost is $100 per computer on the interval from x equals 400 to x equals 600. And let's go and take a look at this graphically as well. We just found the slope of the secant line passing through these two points. And you can see this line is not as steep as the green line. Therefore, the average rate of change is less on this interval. I hope you found this helpful.